We're blooping.
We're what? What did you just say?
I could not have planned that word perfectly. Thank you for not knowing what I was referencing.
I just didn't understand the words that came out of your mouth.
I am Lily.
I am Max. Hey, Maggie.
Hey, Maggie.
You're blooping?
We're blooping.
Blooping.
There's like a TikTok audio that keeps getting repeatedly used, but the original is just a human and their cat, and she's just going bloop, bloop, and booping her, but it's not quite booping, it's blooping, it's, because it's nose to nose.
Yeah.
And someone's recording it and going, what the fuck are you doing? And the human just looks up and goes, we're blooping.
I feel like I have, that sounds familiar now of that bit, but like not the end bit. So like, maybe
we're
I've
blooping.
Seen someone referencing it or something. I don't know. Maggie said, you are booping under mine. I was just hyping even though I didn't get it. What's the bloop?
The bloop?
Is it a show?
No. I think it was just a word she made up. Because, like, to boop an animal is
Oh, no. She says the bloop with, like, capital T, capital B.
Oh.
So it sounds like it's a thing?
I don't know. Unless, is that what you were saying? You were fronting until... you were fronting in support?
It's a YouTube.
Oh.
Ooh, the mysterious sound of the deep oceans. Oh, what?
Cool.
This is 3.5 minutes long. We can watch that later. Thank you for that. It's a mystery.
Do you want to start while I finish my donut?
Yes.
I'm eating a gluten-free mochi donut. Making me really fucking happy, you guys.
Mochi is just, like, the fucking best.
Mm-hmm.
It's
so good. I also had a savory mochi bun on the bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich that I got with this meal. So fucking good.
That sounds wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I would like a mochi bun on a thing.
I didn't think I would,
but like,
it was fucking
I want
delicious.
To try it. Like, yeah.
And it merged, it blended so well with the cheese and the egg.
Mm-hmm.
And it was three very distinct textures, but they were just so good together.
I do need a pillow behind me because I realized that's why I leaned forward all stream last time. Is I like the leaning back is just like too much. So I was like, all right, cool. Now I can actually sit straight. A whetstone.
I'm a very graceful lady.
Look at this, Torvin. dwarf magic happening right there. I thought that was going to be part of the pretty picture, so I'm a little sad that I picked the wrong picture. Is here.
Mm-hmm.
We're playing more
Amen.
Of this game.
Yes.
Shadow
of Mordor?
Thank you.
Brave or stupid.
But it's our last game. It's our last night playing this game. So it's Return of the Ghost, End of the Night, Return of the King. I agree, Maggie. Real gamers have back problems.
That's why real gamers use gamer chairs.
Mm.
Because it gets that lumbar support. Wait, where the fuck did this thing go?
Lumbar. Ayy.
What?
I don't know. I was supporting my co-captain.
Is it like behind this pile?
Is it right there? No. Wait, it's right there.
Oh, that is. It's just in the.
The vines.
Picture time.
Ooh.
We have to go back to get all the picture. I just realized because we don't have all. Of, we can't just do it all here. So it's in the other place.
Thank you, Maggie. Hey, lumbar. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you, Mochi Donut. You have been delicious. I bid you. I bite you.
Hey.
Adieu. Oh no. Oh,
there's
a couple.
Oh,
fine.
What? No, I... Fuck off, game. Dominate. Didn't tell. I don't fucking know. This should not
care.
The flesh render.
That's a fun name.
Not worse, actually. If I use anything about you, you don't have a cool helmet.
Zero crumbs now on this keyboard.
Oh, what?
Thank you for your question, Meg.
Oh,
How was your day, Megan? Particularly dead manning today? How's prep going? You excited?
Here they are, now they see me climbing a tower.
This was what your song made me envision.
I dodged the axe.
Nice.
I don't know how. But it did happen.
Very nice. Intentional dodge.
Oh, dodge another one.
Yeah, I feel that, Maggie. I'm sorry. Tired all the time.
But vacation makes that better.
For how long?
For at least 2 weeks.
For at least the 2 weeks that you're on vacation?
Yes.
I'm hoping to feel rejuvenated during vacation. Jinx, you guys. Because I'm just operating on, like, zero energy. Oh, man. I hope it all comes back to you. Bringing back
coming
all the
back,
energy.
Coming back to me, man.
Yes. It's all... This is... I am envisioning the energy, and I am sending it to you. And let's see, orientation-wise, I think I am actually sending it to you as well, geographically.
Yeah.
It's all coming back to you now!
Just like this random thing I did, this Ooh. Cook's knife I picked up, which just came back to us. A memory.
She feels it. Oh Lord, she feels the spirit. That's what she's saying. Fun fact.
Mm-hmm.
Very unfun fact. And it's not an ulcer. It's period cramps. They've been worse lately. I feel like collectively we've all been having worse period cramps lately.
I wonder if that's like
a time of season thing.
Oh no, just saying because the weather's so fucked. Like if the weather like affects that at all.
Oh,
like,
I wonder.
I know nothing of any of this stuff,
yeah.
So I'm sort of randomly spouting an idea.
I don't know. I know that generally weather fluctuations fuck with like health in general. I know my sibling has a lot of health issues for anyone who doesn't know that. And when they lived in New York, just like having to get, you know, like on an air-conditioned subway train and then off in a crazy hot subway station and like transfer and just going that back and forth through the two different, like vastly different temperature situations really fucked with their immune system.
I'm glad it only gives me headaches because that's at least like easier to deal with. But yeah, if it was like health issues, I would just be dead all the time.
It's unpleasant. Wait, why aren't you going for it?
I want this one first. Which I have to climb this thing to get. It was the rest of the knife.
What did they put in the water?
Oh, we've got half of it.
Oh, that's upsetting. I guess.
I think, or oh no, it was
more
just
than
like,
half.
It was because I clicked into it.
Oh,
that's
okay.
Why.
I was like, "There's got that's more than half."
The I don't know. It was doing a thing which I know last time with our like sword. It was like you did half of it.
Mm.
Here's a random animation.
Oh, right. Interesting.
But I think that was just.
Maggie says, Max, I thought you were a period scientist. Yeah, cold. It's just everything fucks with everything. Our systems are delicate. Our systems, our human systems are delicate. Oh man. Oh, the fun fact though was that my dad.
The rivers of the sea reach beyond the Efel Duoth.
Yes.
If the tribesmen can escape, they could travel north to the sea.
Yes. No. Yes. Ever since he named his car the Tedla, he's just gotten really bad period cramps.
I forgot about the Tedla.
Never forget. But no, he was like 20, 21 or 22 or something, and I asked him about this, and he got really embarrassed, and he said, the reason that I got an ulcer at 22... was because he was simultaneously very stressed. He was in law school, and he was very stressed about law school. And this girl rejected him
for them to have that chance.
Going to an outing. And boy got a fucking ulcer. Because he could not handle or process his emotions. Yay! But he was like, He knew he had an ulcer because he started puking up blood, and they had to take him to the hospital.
That's real bad.
Yeah. So. Agreed. Maggie, in response to what happened to my dad, the hardships of this particular story of my father's. Damn, that sounds really difficult. I always hold the one little space of like, right, his mom died when he was 10. That's kind of the root of a lot of the other things. But this is not one of those things. Yeah, exactly. Damn, that sounds really difficult. I feel really bad. Girl rejected him so hard he started puking blood. Exactly.
I'm curious if he tells that story that way because he doesn't want to admit how stressed out he was at law school.
I think it was sincere embarrassment at the fact that it had quite a bit to do with the girl.
Jeez, that's so ridiculous.
And it wasn't even like the first time he'd been rejected or the first girl that he'd gone out with. Like, I don't know. I don't know. It's been a while since I talked to him about this story, but. Yeah, he thought going to the law school would get him mad bitties. Little did he know, all it got him was an ulcer.
Sorry, I am ignoring the other things. I just want to get all
the picture.
Pieces.
Yeah, no, I'm here for it.
I know we do need to do the main quest, like.
But there's
at
only
some
two
point.
More, right?
Rick, we don't know how long.
That's true. We could. When there's you're done with this area, we could do the first one and then finish up.
Yeah,
okay.
That sounds good. Because, like, we'd have to leave, and maybe we go back to Mordor for, I mean, this is something, but, like, Mordor proper for, oh, this is going to be fun. It's going to be a big conga line.
Oh, boy.
So I have to, yep, go on to this bridge. Cool.
Love it.
Nobody sees me doing any of the shit. But actually, serpentine.
Yes.
I'm on a table for no reason.
Oh!
Always intentionally dodging this accident. Dash. This is a shorter life, actually.
Absolutely. Oh, loving the conga line. We see it.
All the way up there. Yep. Physics. Oh, I got hit in the butt.
No!
But
my booty!
I don't see it anymore. I hate when we get close and just like, this isn't there anymore. Mm. It's somewhere in this tower, I'm assuming.
I mean, the fact that we could get all the way up here. There we go.
Okay.
Nice. What? Oh. Is that Sauron or is that Celebrimbor? Is the main guy in the middle just Celebrimbor?
I think it's Celebrimbor, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, cool! Maggie Googled it!
Google what?
You are a period scientist!
Wait, what? I had an MD and I didn't know.
Indeed! The weather does affect periods. If you stay inside a lot and don't get vitamin D, apparently it can make your cramps worse, which explains why when I've been quarantining, it's worse.
Yeah. Oh, that's
gotta get that vitamin D. Hey. Cancel this software update. OBS, what you doing? Nice.
Yeah, this is 100% here more. That's the hammer head that. Right, we got one more. Nope. One more in here. Then I will definitely just teleport out because no one sees me. Because I am complete stealth. I have not started a riot in this fortress. Oh, 100% thought I was just going to auto die there. I do like that this is a. You
yeah.
could actually stealth your whole way through this fortress.
Oh, true.
Guess I can't go that way. And I indicated to follow an order. What a liar!
Oh. Nice.
It was alright. I meant to do my hit the wrong like self-reflection for my review, because that's coming up while on vacation.
Mm-hmm.
And didn't get any of that done, so...
Oh, that's okay. Cool. She said she was sorry for not asking how our days were. Or maybe yours specifically?
That's fine.
I just gave you lots of hugs. Consensual hugs.
Consensual hugs.
Very important. We stand. Consensual hugs.
How do I get into this place?
Thank you, Maggie.
Here. I'm gonna follow this wall.
Nice. Yeah, this whole week has been interesting for me. I think I am comfortable saying this on stream, because I'm confused and I don't get it. My engineering manager told me to quit yesterday. That there was no way I would possibly be able to get a raise in the next 3 to 6 months, and I can't get a raise without getting a promotion. Which
also is a straight up lie.
Yeah, it just feels really wrong, and is also not how I got my last raise. So he told me that I should quit, basically, in so many words. He said that he's been in my position, and when he was in my position, he quit and got a new job 2 weeks later. And I said, Rimsky, what you're telling me is that it's in my best interest, sorry, said his name, to quit. And he said, I'm not telling you what to do, I want you to stay, you gotta do what's best for you. Yeah, great manager. Really the best.
Around. No way he could ever let you down. He's the best.
Yeah, so it's been a weird few days. I have not gotten a lot of coding done. Shocking, I know. It's been messy. My class also, a lot of my students are like rioting, because we just started doing Django stuff, and it's hard, and they don't feel set up for success, and I don't feel like we have had the time to set them up for success. I just had a meeting, two JTC meetings, actually, back-to-back before this. JTC is the program that I teach for, and, the TAs who took the program last semester as students think that we're setting them up better this time around, and that like it should be totally doable. They'll just need to watch the videos again and again and like put in the work that they're not feeling like they want to put in, the students. So we'll see how everything turns out. A lot of stuff feels very up in the air at the moment. And I guess I need to start practicing for job interviews, because my engineering manager told me to quit. So.
Huzzah.
Maggie liked your rendition of the song. The saddest rendition of that song ever, and it was apropos.
And I couldn't put a cheerful tune.
No. Wait, but you're not looking, are you, Maggie? Because you're fucking getting your promotion. You're fucking getting your raise. Yeah, I last time I was job interviewing, I paid for LeetCode Premium, and it was super, super clutch. But I spoke to my mentor, Nate, and he also recommended a couple of... I don't know if they were like, I'm not sure what the format is, but reading to do on system design to get me closer to to like really senior
because that's the
strength.
Like actual distinguishing thing.
Yeah, and I don't have expertise in that, so.
And also, the system you worked on didn't have good system design.
Oh yeah, look at that. Funny how those things are connected.
Hello.
Nice, okay. Cool. love that. I super love that for you. But thank you so much that you would be my interview partner, even though you're not interviewing. Thank you. That shit's expensive.
Oh yeah.
That shit, the energy and time that goes into that is, I appreciate that offer so much.
Not to distract from this moment, but there's one here. Oh my god, how the fuck did I miss that? I was already in the fortress.
Did we get all of the ones from the other side?
No, but I know that there's ones that are on this side that we need to get, which I was just like trying to get all those first. Yeah. And sorry, I was gonna ask you to like stare at the map with me as I tried to find them, but I found two, so I was like, you guys, you're gonna get my map. All right.
No, he says come to PG, join our cult.
It's true. I mean, all startups are a cult.
This is true.
Some like most cults, they usually fall apart pretty quick.
Ranger! It's a room.
I mean,
might as well pick it up.
Yeah. While we're here, doing other stuff. No.
I said this to someone out loud the other day. I can't remember. I think it was because I was watching Lizzo's reality TV show with a couple of friends, and there was a conversation where one of the dancers, like her number one dream was to be a dancer, and her number two dream, was to move to South Korea. She was half Korean, and be a teacher. But the cultural differences of there was a challenge where they had to take a semi-nude photo, not truly nude at all, but just like pose with minimal clothes on, and she was really really struggling with it because she said, you know, like if I do this and that's anywhere on the internet, then I'm releasing the opportunity to do anything but this, basically.
Oh, that's rough.
Yeah, and had her do it. I mean, they basically were like, I mean, it's your choice, but if you don't do it, you know, they're gonna see that as you not doing the challenge and not committing 100%. And so she decided to do it. I was thinking about that aspect, and then also the aspect of our culture that made that feel necessary for her, that like she had to do that in order to have this opportunity, and that like you would have to embrace that element of yourself in order to be able to do this opportunity. And yeah, culture is a cult.
Yeah.
Culture is absolutely a fucking cult. From the line down.
Stop. Nope. Please go down. Thank you, sir.
Innovation. Oh god, yeah, Max, I hope you're ready for some reality TV. We love reality TV on vacation. You watched the first season of The Circle? Wait, but you were so mad about Love Island.
Love Island and The Circle are very different. From having watched bits of both.
What is The Circle? Which one is The Circle?
It's the fake Facebook one where they can't see each other.
Oh, yeah. I can't watch The Circle.
It's a show of basically gaslighting each other.
Yeah! I can't fucking watch The Circle. It's horrible. It's so painful to watch.
I mean, but then again, Love Island is also a show of gaslighting each other. Like, they're both very...
The rules are so much clearer, I feel. You know, like, you're not there specifically to lie to each other.
I mean,
the assumption
not there to lie
is
to
meant...
each other on The Circle either.
Right,
there's
the people
who... Like, that is their role in that game.
And their methodology. Well, which is totally valid, Maggie. You are absolutely allowed to hate Love Island.
I do feel like
I don't hold it against you in any way.
There's different types of peoples on those two shows, even though they do similar things. Okay, so we've got all the picture we can get here, I think.
Cool.
I think we have to go back to Mordor to do the rest of the picture.
All right.
Should we do that now, or should we do the objective?
Up to you. It's 8:26.
Let's go back to Mordor. Can I just click this button, or do I have to, like, walk?
I hope so. Travel to Dune. Thank you. There must be a better life. Part of my frustration with that also was being trapped in a cabin where I literally couldn't go anywhere except my room, which was right next to the living room. Hindsight 2020, shouldn't have had the room that was right next to the living room on my trip. I may have manifested some other frustrations I was experiencing through my fury at Love Island. As again, you are within your rights to do.
I would say, it was a nice room. It was the worst location for that room. It was like all windows.
Yeah.
Got a private exit. Like, it was...
But if any of us wanted to be out on the patio, it wasn't that private.
Yeah, no, exactly. We had to have, like, the blinds closed, like, all the time. But yeah, like...
Oh, and Maggie, I saw your text this morning. Thank you so much. I need to check something because there is a concert on my birthday in New York that...
Is that all of it? There's just a big hole in the middle? We got the achievements. That must be all of it. Let's scroll.
Yeah.
Oh, 32 out of 32? Yeah, we got all of it. I don't like that there's a big hole in the middle. Why the fuck's there a big hole in the middle?
Also, tell us something about it, you guys. The achievement should come with some fucking lore. Oh.
I'm the Bright Lord of Mordor, the silver hand that drives back the darkness, reaching through the fog of night to avenge those long betrayed, arise from the fields of death and march forth from the shadows. The purifying flames of war, you who were once Eldar, shall be reforged beneath my hammer. The bringer of gifts, the betrayer, shall be unmade. Renounce the blessed realm, to redeem the Lord of Land of Shadows, and bind the walls of Arada. In place of the Dark Lord, you shall have light undiminished, and all shall fear me and rejoice.
Okay, well that doesn't bode well.
Yeah, this is... He's fucking nutso.
Wait, hit square though?
Nani here, Galar
Mordor. Oh, speaking in Elvish.
Yeah.
Cool. So, okay, he's got... Elves and orcs, I think, are the only things on this drawing. Oh, because you got the spirit knife. That's what he's holding. I was like, what is that thing? Because he doesn't... Yeah, he's the hammer is this big thing, but he's got that.
Interesting.
Alright. I'm still bummed that this doesn't feel complete because of that, like, text hole.
I mean, yeah, I guess it's like, it's four different phrases, but they're just very separate. Rand and Alex B. are down for the weekend so far, and one of my friends said that maybe we'll do... Oh, awesome! Okay, cool. I will keep you posted. I'll let you know. But exciting.
And we don't give a fuck if we don't get all the artifacts, right?
Absolutely not.
Cool.
Yeah.
Picture I felt like there was like a commitment to like actually finish the artifacts.
And that wasn't...
Who gives a fuck?
It's a bummer that... It is not. The picture was rather anticlimactic.
Yeah. So we've got all of that. We are only missing 12 artifacts, but not worth... We're missing 3 nature things. Whatever the fuck that means.
We would have to go... Ooh,
three people.
Hi.
Oh, I wonder if it's just like we do the quest and it unlocks these things for people and nature. Because these are all in order.
Interesting.
Or we just didn't find 3 plants. No, this was not just... Yeah, there's just 3 things I'll pop up at the end of the sec.
Alright.
Same with lore.
Ooh, that's cute. I'm good to do...
That was our first artifact. Mm-hmm. Murder.
Murder. Murder. Let's do the first quest, yeah. I am drinking the illustrious, rare, delicious, although that one's not facetious. Boda box wine?
You talk about this all the time. I don't know why you were hyping this up more as if it was something different.
Maggie asked me what wine I was drinking.
Okay.
Yeah, Franzia. I'm drinking arsenic. Lame. We are not thin enough.
Could I have just gone around and gone through the doorway? Yes. Am I going to do that? Fuck no.
Absolutely not. What are you talking about?
Oh.
Ooh.
Your forces await your command. The time has come to launch your assault against the Black Hand. Isn't the Black Hand the name of something from
some
other show?
We wish to thank you for coming to
it
our aid.
Sounds really familiar.
Is that what the thing is called in,
Never realized my
the Iron Fist?
So appreciated by the Queen.
They're here.
Orcs.
That sounds vaguely familiar. I never finished watching that show, I don't think.
Oh, I mean, you were not missing much.
I never watched the final season of Daredevil. I never watched...
Oh.
I don't think I finished Iron Fist.
Hmm.
Watched all Defenders. That was bad.
Yeah, that was like... that. Honestly, it was the most fun one, though, because it was just like, let's just throw all this shit together.
Yeah, it was a lot of... Yeah, Daredevil, I feel like I should go back to Daredevil and watch the final season, because that was like the series I liked the most.
Yeah.
Mm.
Jessica Jones. First season,
I feel like I don't.
Oh, yeah, I didn't like the second season.
I should think as long as I like.
Now, actually. Oh, there's plot happening. We're just talking right over it.
We owe you our lives, Tanya.
Thank you. Oh, took me a minute.
My lady.
Milady. I mean...
Milady.
To be fair... Oh, wait, no!
Oh, we're on a boat!
I was gonna say, everyone in Middle-earth has neckbeards, because, like, they don't shave properly, so they do have neckbeards, but also he doesn't. He just has a proper, like, beard on his just chin, which doesn't make sense, because he's from Middle-earth.
Plot hole!
Wait, oh, so we just went...
I call a plot hole!
Somewhere else?
I guess so. We missed the plot.
I don't really care. I'm just like...
Lugash, please.
Oh, are these the... Oh, no, we possessed him, right?
Did we? I couldn't... His eyes looked it, but everyone else's looked more. What? This is our entire army? These,
maybe
like, six dudes behind us?
Maybe it's just the commander?
They say he's a monster who'll poison our minds and bathe in our blood to cheat the cling of death.
Yep.
I say there is no greater monster than the mighty Uruk-hai.
Yeah.
Tear his limbs.
The voice said, good to see you, hide.
Today we feast on
what?
Man.
Because she was possessed by Saruman. She goes, thanks, bro. And he goes, m'lady.
He's apparently our nemesis. He who flees is our nemesis.
You're just going in a circle?
Oh, I want to get to him. Oh, yeah, because... Oh, wait. Yeah, we got our captains.
Okay, but we got to protect our captains.
But one of our captains has the flaming arrows that just murders everyone.
We got to protect him.
Fine, I'll protect someone.
Imagine the ground pound. Yes! The ground pound fire arrow combo? Incredible. Defeat your nemesis. This is hilarious.
He's also just like standing over. Oh, he's a spear eater, dude. Sorry, man. As someone like that one.
Yeah, I think he might just be blind. Yeah, I agree with you. Critical hit.
Oh my god. We all got bombed. I think most of the enemy dudes are gone, and who flees is just gonna start fleeing. So
ooh, our fire dude is struggling now.
No. We killed all of them. That was the bad guy. He was the low health. All of our dudes were at full health.
I think one of our dudes had half health. Or like three quarters.
Oh, shit. Right, I forgot we have to do this.
Oh, you killed him? You didn't?
No, we have to kill him.
Oh. Power vacuum.
Did not get him anyway. Good riddance.
Ooh, that's an epic.
I'm a little bit sad that we finally killed...
Oh, we don't need that.
Skullface? Because Skullface would have been a great nemesis to
have
at the end here.
That's true. Or Fish Guy.
Yeah. I don't know why Fish Guy wasn't there, actually. Hmm.
He's still alive, right?
Good. Yes.
Hey, more like his head flees, am I right?
Hey.
Indeed you
what?
Maggie, how was your day? I meant to ask that earlier, and then shockingly, I got distracted.
What does this do? Increase the range of attract.
Yeah.
Do we go fight the Eye of Sauron now?
Isn't it the hand?
No, the...
Oh, like the actual... Well,
that's how
that'd be hilarious.
The third age video game ends, is you end up on the plateau.
Oh my god.
And you literally fight the eye.
Why?
The best fucking ending to a game ever.
But how is that even...
What is happening? Let me climb this, please. Thank you.
Again, day was okay, just very tired. Ooh, you're leading a project! That's awesome! Congratulations!
Those are just skeleton people. Wait, what?
Is that Celebrimbor? Where'd all our orcs go?
And we shall sit on the Iron Throne.
Men.
Bow to me.
Oh, this is the weird math
dude. I will deliver you to the Dark Lord. Unspoiled.
Be bowed to no one.
The Dark Lord forgives you, Celebrimbor. Return to him and cast off.
This is a very large man.
Walls. Stand up and fight. There's no need, Ranger. Celebrimbor is your curse. He chose you.
Silence!
And he can release you at any time.
But they need each other because they love each other.
Is that what's been happening? Is that the plot that we've been missing?
You are, Ranger. A vessel for the ring. As you wish.
Ooh, throwing a little Princess Bride in there? Oh! Stealth drain the Black Captain.
What joy it is to fight such things. Such pain.
You want to L1 to switch to...
Mine.
I think we just have to go to the mic.
Okay.
We have 8 minutes. How is this time?
Okay, we're in the green area.
Why didn't you die?
Okay.
Wait, so I want to make sure that he's...
Yeah. Nice. Oh, shit. Nice.
There he is. Halfway through a spike. Hoping to get it to a place where it's ready by him. Should we?
Oh, he's draining us.
Oh.
Why does it insta die? Okay. Well.
Oh, these are all the captain?
Yes. You so, like, to find our one that we want to stealth drain. I think it's the gimmick.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, the tower. Oh, let me climb! Game! Headbutt. Punch.
He's me when I talk too much at meeting. My lips get stuck to my gums!
Do you think he was born in the dark? I'm loving the stealth from above. That's gonna be the thing that we're gonna need to do quite a bit.
Yeah.
Oh wow, yeah, no, probably just two more times.
Okay. Hopefully none of them noticing me after that. Yeah, imagine if we didn't have the death from above or stealth from above thing.
Oh,
how shitty this
impossible.
Would be.
It would be impossible. My execution of that question. Thank you. I'm glad you approve. Nice.
Oh, stealth rain. Let's go.
Swish. One more. Oh, go to Yoreth.
I can't go as much as you want.
Interesting. Oops.
Who's Yoreth? Is that like our wife or something?
Probably. Oh, yeah.
You will never see your family again.
Are you pressing the button? Okay.
That's the reason I picked it with my left hand. Because like the odds of it being the left stick quick time event were very low compared to hitting a different button.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. Dude, cut his...
I guess we don't have our knife anymore.
Cut his head off. Cut his head off. Oh, okay, that's fine. That works too.
Yeah, also, this is fire. Are we okay?
We're,
I know we're immortal, but like...
Well, no, we're also resistant to fire. That's why we can explode things, right?
Right.
Oh, he just wants to make out.
You're so angry, cursed. You deceived me.
It was Sauron's doing. This was your doing!
Okay, we still have our dagger.
I should have died with my family.
I thought you wanted revenge. I can't leave you. There is only one way to close the circle.
Your cycle is not complete.
Black Hand remains.
Hey! Oh, Maggie, you gotta watch this terrible ass show. The first season really is just the one that you gotta get through, and the last three are just cinema.
Minus some episodes.
Yes, yes, certainly.
We must now fight the tower again.
One of my favorite Will Smith slap memes that I've seen is there's the picture of the slap, and then is it Scorsese turned around his shoulder and it says, "This is cinema." That's pretty funny. 12 Monkeys, my personal favorite show of all time.
Do we go back to the corner? Oh, exactly.
No,
that's
flames. We must return to Queen Marwyn. The Black Hand has been here. I can feel it.
Was that not the Black Hand?
Who the fuck did we just kill?
That was the Black Mouth?
But then who was the first dude we killed also? We've killed like a bunch of these dudes and they've never had names, but it's always been the Black Hand. It's like none of them have been the Black Hand.
Yeah, I don't know.
We have an ability point spent.
Ooh, what should we
do? Do we have any other like nonsense quests that we want to do?
Digital C, if you're lurking and there's anything you want us to do, now is the time to let us know. Wow, Maggie, sorry, adjusting. That is an impressively long time to have not known what that was about. The Will Smith
stuff. Oh.
Bravo.
I still, like, am very confused by it. Like, what was going through his brain to be oh, this is it. Like, gonna do this now. Like,
that I don't think we'll know.
Yeah.
I also don't think it was, like, the worst thing that he slapped him.
I can just get this with... We can just skip
this
here. I mean, we're doing this because we want to turn invisible.
Mm-hmm.
But then we need to just... This system... Oh, because there's no lines between them. Mm. We could have just started with saving our points and gotten these immediately.
Damn it.
Fuck this game for not being exceptionally clear about some of this shit.
Because Kat messaged me and asked how I was feeling about the news, and I looked at the news and then realized she meant my teammate leaving after reading an article about Jim Carrey's reaction. Fantastic. How do you feel about your teammate leaving? Also, how do you feel about running a thing?
Mortar and Flames, you return to Nern to discover the Black Hand has been here before you.
Dun dun dun. Oh.
I am not worth your vengeance, father. Why do you fight?
Ooh.
Is that our son saying that?
Yeah.
We will be together soon. Forever.
This was the Queen's house?
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Soon, Kelebor. Soon.
Guessing it's Black Hand's voice?
Unless it's meant to be Sauron.
Oh. Do we ever hear this?
Oh! Hi!
He wants this.
Why do you just have what they want?
Took it from the...
He gave this to us earlier.
Yeah, I thought we did.
Are we gonna just put it on? Or are we gonna have another ghost moment? No, because we already ghost moments.
Maybe not. I guess not.
I could
have
sworn we did
the ground. Jumped in the lava, man.
Because he's lost the power.
The precious. He must have it.
Gollum. Oops. As you say, Gollum has bitten off every single one of our fingers.
It was mine to keep.
Oh, shit.
Be gone.
Sauron knows we're here.
Let's not keep him waiting.
So is the idea that he's alive because he wraithified in the way that, like...
Oh.
...ended?
Whoa.
This also, like, goes completely against the lore explanation Matt posted about, like, the, like, 5-minute explainer. Like, oh yeah, how the rings, like, were corrupted people, and, like, what that evilness meant and stuff. I was like, oh, cool, well...
No, we're writing over Caridor.
I don't know. This game was not well thought out.
Very fun to play.
No Lord of the Rings games are.
Really?
Or, like, they don't, like, the plot is Third Age... The entire plot is that you are the Bee Fellowship, like, unrelated to them, but you're following them the entire time, like, literally a step behind them. Kind of meet occasionally, like, you run into Gandalf when he's on the bridge and just said, everyone go. Oh, you guys are here. I guess you'll fight with me now. And, like, you fight with Gandalf for no reason. And then you run away, and then he falls. And it's like, you just keep being behind him the whole Fellowship the whole time, which makes no fucking sense. In this game of, like, what the fuck is this plot?
I come for you, Lord of Gifts.
I mean, we're going to go this way, so not fighting anything, right?
I guess so. Oh, those are all ours.
We just watched them all get killed. Oh no, there's 5 other generals.
First Talon of the Hand.
Claw. He hates Caragors, but we rode in on a Carag. Oh, we made him stronger because he hates Caragors.
Oh,
no, he's our friend.
Oh, fantastic.
You're too late, Ranger. Barad-dûr is rebuilt. Mount Doom is aflame. The Fall of Men is here, and Sauron will conquer all.
I laugh at you too. Sauron, probably. I laugh at you, Sauron.
Battle for Middle Earth seems pretty fun. I watched my brother play that for a while.
Battle for Middle Earth games are, yes, because those like basically follow the plot of the movies. So those are quite good. Yes. I resent my all the games are bad. Oh, I just attacked a bunch of our dudes. Whatever.
Yeah, Maggie, that it does seem unnecessarily tricky that you had to start this project.
You killed the fourth talent.
Great.
Because flaming arrows did it, I'm sure. I've just been running around, swinging my sword left and right, barely paying attention. So, first talent's dead. I helped with that.
Indeed. that you had to start before you took 2 weeks off, that seems not setting you up for success as much as that could have been.
Oh, I killed our own dude, but I got a Mind Slayer with that. That's good, right? That's our dude. Nope. Why'd I get off?
Oh, that's good. Love that. Too basic is it not to worry too much. Wow.
Where's my character back at? I want my character back. I'm gonna wait.
I want my character back.
Oh, second one's dead. I'm glad I'm helping so
much.
Great.
I'm really enjoying this fight. You're doing such a good job. Just killing it.
Oh, we got two left. Okay. Well, I'll murder this one. I'll help.
Watch him die before you get there.
One more slash. There we go.
He did it, guys!
I did get backhanded very badly in this one. Oh,
last one's back
at
full power. Ooh, not invulnerable to range.
I was really hoping it'd be another one of those like insta kills like that other one.
That was too good.
Oop, nice. Oh, fire time. I do love that we've got fucking fire launcher on our side. It just makes this like unfair and hilarious. Stop auto targeting our own dude. Then don't prompt me to auto kill my own dude. Game.
Oh, his health went back up. I think he is not only invulnerable to fire, but it enrages him so he gets so bad.
There's literally nothing we can do aside from murdering our own dude then.
Can you circle through his
He's
on the ground.
Oh, he's almost dead. Oh, his shield's gone. He's only got the shield. Or it just didn't render? What?
Bye!
Thanks, friend.
Yep. You literally mostly hit your own people.
Yep. A great captain. We don't need any of those.
Oh, wait, go back for the flower. Ooh. Right, to your left. Or to your right.
This will finish as it started, with shadow and flame falling on the black gate. The hammer and the tar are dead.
Wait a sec. LOL!
What?
Remember when we started and 50 dudes descended on us? That was right here.
No fucking way!
This is literally where it started.
Ah!
And where we almost dropped this game. So you're claiming that you guys are the reason that this all happens this way. I see.
I mean, I guess it's better than if Sauron was able to walk around outside of Mordor.
Do I climb?
That is really interesting that the main giant enemy of the like the biggest potentially fantasy story of all time is non-corporeal, basically.
It's a man behind the curtain.
Yeah. But
that's
usually
also,
at the end, you know, like, something comes out that you need to battle.
Well, I mean, it's very much like the... I mean, there's a lot of religious stuff in here. Like, it's Satan
yeah.
is always a thing behind the curtain, never, like, a real,
yeah.
real thing you actually have to deal with. It's just, like, temptation and such. And...
Oh, we're just scaling this wall. I don't know why I'm surprised by that. What we do...
Wasn't this the first dude we killed?
This is the dude who slaughtered our families, trying to bring Celebrimbor into himself.
He's not as fucked up as his two apprentice dudes.
Yeah, I guess not.
He's also a Sith Lord.
Is it just a memory?
No, he has an orc army. He did this before.
Oh no! He did this before his family was killed? Oh, he's the reason his family was killed.
Yeah. Which, like, he was threatened that his family would die, and now they die. Or does he kill his family?
He might kill his family.
Oh. Yeah, that makes sense. The ring wants to be with him.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bioshock. Obey me. Kill me.
To stand by his side. Now I give you no choice. Sealed together in death. So be it.
Oh.
What? This is not gonna be. Yeah, there's no other fight.
No.
This is just story now. We finished this way quicker than I thought we would.
Yeah. Also, nothing that just happened made any sense whatsoever.
Nope, it makes as much sense as fighting the eye, like the literal eye. So wait, he wants to move on. He's done with his revenge, I guess.
Supposedly just been around.
Or like fucking shit up. I mean, I guess that's what the second game is about, is how they...
There's a second game?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, there was,
Why?
Digital C definitely mentioned it
a couple
times.
New ring.
Oh, what? What? Shadow of Mordor sequel.
The Hand is Severed. That's the name of the achievement we just got. Blood Friendship.
Shadow of War, that's the sequel. Came out in 2017.
What's the point of it?
King's previous game's narrative, which is based on sit between the events of The Hobbit and Lord of the Rings. Continues the story of Rage Italian. As they forge a new ring of power to amass an army to fight against Sauron. The game builds upon the Nemesis system. Which it is supposed to be better in that game than this one.
Okay.
The game follows in several races, including Uruks and Ulogs. I've never heard of an Ulog before, but I like the name. generally favorable reception, mixed with the predecessor, aims towards the gameplay, improved Nemesis system with the story elements, and changes made to establish characters to use some negative reactions, as well as the inclusion of microtransactions and loot boxes. Talion, Trippy. Kirby War, Alistair Duncan.
Alistair Duncan. Who dat?
It's the voice of the Kirby.
No, I know, but like, who dat?
I'm sorry. I'm opening that up, so I.
There are 10 rings.
He was in Buffy the Vampire Slayer as Collins.
Collins? We need a picture.
It's just the.
We need a picture!
You have the technology right next to you.
Fine. I'm keeping an eye on chat, right? He's talking to us. One for each Lord of the Ring game. It's called Canon.
He's Peter Vello in NCIS. He's Mordecai's dad and Pilgrim in the regular show. He was in Sabrina Teenage Witch as Pierre Curie.
Oh. This guy.
Oh, that guy looks familiar.
Mm-hmm. Alistair Duncan.
He was the voice of Alfred in The Batman.
Hey. Ooh, that's what he looks like now.
Oh.
Scottish! He's a Scottish actor and real estate broker.
What?
To each their own.
He's been Alfred in a lot of Batman stuff, actually.
Oh, he was in God of War. Or maybe this is just a trailer. Separate from... No, God of War.
Oh, in the
Mimir.
New one? Oh, he's Mimir.
Huh.
Oh, damn. Okay, cool.
Love that.
He was also in another God of War before he was Mimir as the Soldier number 8 and Citizen Male number 7.
Look at you moving up in the God of War
Oh, he's Curtis Blackburn from Killer 7. Okay. I've heard this man in many games, which is like why it's like he was at Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End as a Penrod.
Interesting. Yeah, he was Celebrimbor on both.
He was in Tomb Raider Legend.
Yeah, he was in Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, I haven't played that one. No. Okay, so enough about this man, the plot. They travel Mount Doom where they forge a new ring of power free of Sauron's corruption. However, once the ring is complete, Caribou was abducted and held hostage by Shelob.
The spider,
who asked Talion to hand over the ring in exchange for Erebor. Talion reluctantly agrees, gives the ring to Shelob, who claims they have a common enemy in Sauron. That doesn't make any sense.
No.
Shelob just like her own.
Mm-hmm.
No. She uses the ring to see into the future and directs Talion to the last Gondorian stronghold near Morda, Minas Ilith, which is under siege by Sauron's forces due to the city's possession of a valuable Palantir. Palantir allows whoever to talk to see anything they wish, making valuable to Obi-Wan. That's the first paragraph. Goes there, comes to Oz Celebrimbor, wants to help
the content y'all are here for. We're just reading
this
the plot.
This does not sound good.
No, we're reading the plot of the second one because we finished the game.
They get the ring back. They start dominating orcs and building an army again. Talion faces Isildur.
Oh.
The north. Corrupted into a Nazgul? What?
Wait, what? Italian is?
No.
Isildur?
What? That doesn't make any sense.
I'm so confused.
his memories of how he was corrupted by the One Ring, he decides to destroy Isildur and releases his spirit rather than dominating him. Oh my god, this keeps going. Talion doesn't have the ring or care anymore, so he starts to die. He's visited by Shelob in a vision. Shelob just shows up a bunch in this.
It's such
he a kills the Witch
choice.
King? No, he uses the power of Isildur's ring to assault and siege Minas Morgul, defeating the Witch King in the process. He gets the Palantir back. Oh my god, what? Decades later.
Oh my god.
He joins Sauron's forces as a Nazgul.
Mm.
When he dies with the rest of the Nazgul, his spirit is freed. He's shown the last shores. Okay. So he kills a Nazgul and takes its place, is how they get around him killing a Nazgul. Sure. Mission complete, 1,000 XP. Congratulations, you defeated the Black Hand of Sauron, driven Sauron back to the ruins of Barad-dûr. However, the Dark Lord's shadow remains. Hold back the rising tide of his army.
Well. What do we want to do for the next 52 minutes?
What other games do we
also,
have?
Also, hi friends. We can just play Bloodborne for 42 minutes.
We don't have it. Are you logged into your account?
I think so. Didn't we do this?
Insert disc. The disc is down there if you want to grab it.
Can. Do you want to catch up on chat? Ninja and Digital C popped up.
Oh, perfect. This doesn't have. Yeah, you have to sign to PlayStation Network.
Oh, we didn't do that?
No, we just made sure it was connected to the internet and did updates. Which we'd have to type your passport on stream.
Yeah, never mind.
Which
never
we
mind,
can change the stuff so it doesn't show that, but.
What should we play instead? Chat, what should we play instead? We have got.
Please take a picture of Shelob from Shadow of War. Oh, look up a picture of Shelob. Oh,
I was gonna say, we're not fucking playing it.
Oh my god, wait.
Is it because you know what she looks like and you want us to share the ridiculousness?
Shadow of War.
Okay.
She's a lady.
What?
She's just a lady. What?
Why? How?
Because they knew that they couldn't have a spider be the main character of, or one of their main characters.
So why would they pick Shelob? A spider!
Yes, I did know there was a molasses flood in Boston in the 20s, actually. There's a thing that came up a bunch.
Interesting.
with friends in Boston. I don't know why. Actually, it came up from Dan, mostly.
Oh, Journey, Outer Wilds.
Journey.
Wait, is this stuff that's actually here?
These are things installed, I believe.
Digital C.
PlayStation Network. Outer Wilds, we would just like start exploring that game, and then it'd be a kind of a letdown to stop.
Okay.
Journey, we could have.
Assassin's Creed Valhalla. Oh, Dishonored. I think you gave us Dishonored. Yes.
Yes.
Dishonored.
Oh, these are ones that are installed, but may or may not need discs.
Okay. Well, the ones that we have the discs for, we have Dishonored. We have Okami.
Yeah, Journey's like 1 or 2 hours, so like, yeah, we could have possibly gotten very far in that.
We do have Bloodborne.
We just start a new Bloodborne game?
Oh, God. Immediately exhausted. we could replay Final Fantasy VII for 40 minutes. Horizon Zero Dawn. Dark Souls 3. Ooh.
Well, so the ones that aren't installed... Actually, Shadow of the Colossus. We could play the first Colossus in that. That would be like 40 minutes.
I'm down. You guys want to
watch
that?
Assuming it doesn't require getting installed. Jackbox, need more shirts. We could do Jackbox.
Could do Jackbox.
Horizon Zero Dawn is so good. I mean, it would be a good stream game if we...
Weren't taking 2 weeks off.
Taking 2 weeks off.
Yeah.
Right. That's the... We could just do a game of Jackbox.
Sure.
Just, like, someone have Jackbox to host, and then we could stream the stuff here. It's mega long. Okay. Because I don't think I own any Jackboxes, actually.
Ooh. Let me, I'll be right back while you guys set
it
up.
What do you have on Steam? We could play something you've got on Steam.
We could. Could we both play it?
We would have to connect the controller to your laptop. Which I think we only have one controller, so no, I don't think so. You could walk us through Stardew Valley for.
Oh God.
We could
try. I've been slowly grabbing all the platinum stars from Overcooked 2.
Oh yeah.
We could just play bouts of 3 minutes of intense paying attention while I don't say anything.
I would be curious to see you play solo Overcooked 2, because like, I don't know how it works as a solo game.
Sure.
I'm very curious about that. Would y'all be down with that?
Talk amongst yourselves. I'll be back.
Next, it shows how to be a pro.
Hey.
I'm confirming I don't have Jackbox right now, though. I do not have any Jackbox games. I think I just have one Drawful. Yeah, I got Drawful 2. Your PSN account is still on this machine, Digital C, but we are not in it. So, like, there's stuff on this machine that is, like, installed, that, like, the data is here, but, like, we don't have access to it kind of thing. We could go into your profile and possibly have access to it, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go back to Shadow of Mordor, so we're not just looking at PlayStation stuff. Only one machine can be signed in an account at a time. Could look up before I was sent. Okay, cool. No, I think we're like for any of these games, we just start a new game, so we don't need to use your account for anything. and unless you've got like digital stuff that we could steal, but hey, pun intended. I don't think Lily has an intention to play Elden Ring anytime soon, but I could propose that to her as a thing. Oh, I'm gonna go test out our invisibility power, because I never did that before. I'm gonna run up to these dudes' faces. Be like, yo, I'm here. Look at me. Look at me vanish. Wait, I'm not vanishing. How do I vanish? Wait. When in stealth mode, R2 then press those down. Okay. You see nothing. I'm invisible and you're all getting fucked up real bad. This is hilarious. I guess I missed one. Yo, Lily.
Hi.
The invisible power is fucking hilarious. It doesn't matter if they're like, I was there, all of them were staring at me.
Uh-huh.
You go into stealth mode and press down on the thumbsticks. You slow time and are invisible, so you can just, I murdered like 15 people in a row, and then there's this one dude left, he's like, surround him! Because he didn't realize all of his friends were dead.
Nice. Ooh. Sorry, y'all. I went upstairs to get lotion for my face, because I don't know if you could tell, but it was dying. My lips were so chapped. But then my roommate is watching Desperate Housewives. Did it make it to the mic?
I heard you say Housewives?
Oh, no.
I don't think that made it to the mic.
The thing that I was hoping made it to the mic was that the scene that I saw her watching is Eva Longoria's character was explaining to the like teenager she's trying to have an affair with. She's like, my husband bought this table from Italy like something, something, something. I walked out of my room and I just said, fuck me on it. And I really was really hoping that just that, with no context, made it down here. Ooh, man.
Okay. Digital C said that you can have access to any of his games that, like, are, like, you can do, like, the install using his profile stuff. I don't know how that works, but he did say you could play Elden Ring. As long as you accept getting kicked off whenever he's playing.
Oh, that's valid and acceptable.
But I said I don't think you're going to play anytime soon because it's too
stressful.
Stressed
out.
And he said, yeah, Elden Ring is stressful and hard, but also fun. And hard.
I feel like that'd be a fun one to play once you have played it, and I have not, and so we have, like, one person who knows things and can be like, if we're, like, failing to do something, you can be like...
I'm far enough along where I can, like...
Yeah. So, sure. Like, I would honestly be down to start Elden Ring when you get back, but if you don't want to be playing it...
we'd have to play it at my place.
Oh, that's okay. Oh, so after class. So probably in the summer when I'm back from LA.
Yeah.
Cool.
But yeah, we could definitely do that. Also, yeah, you do make a good point, Jersey. Like, we could play with a different, like, build than I have. I'm doing, like, a strength build because I haven't done that in Dark Souls game before and I, like, want to try it out. And because I normally do, like, faith builds. But magic builds are also, like, a way to make the game just easier. And, like, not have to, like... There's some, like, very broken magics and stuff. And, like, magic just is, like, cool. You can just, like, do some stuff and just, like, not have to worry about things. And it's, like, a way to play the game faster. So, like, we could do a run through as magic.
Certainly.
Like you said, I've only played for a few hours and I gotta get to that grind. I'm Sword and Shield and still figuring out the whole thing. Love the bow, though. Do I have the pizza cutter yet? No, I haven't gone to the lava manor, whatever it's called. I'm doing, like, cleaning up, like, quests that are in, like, areas before that because I know that it, like, prevents some quests from happening by going there. I also need to run into the lady who teleports you to, like, the area there, and I thought she was in one place, and I just saw the wiki, she's somewhere else, so I need to do that. And, do a Tathian Inquisitor, go to Gyoza's pizza cutter. So yeah, do you want to do...
Yeah, sure, codes? How do we...
If you go to scene desktop view, and if you load up Overcooked... We can then transition to it.
Oh, it's gonna be mega fucking loud.
No, because we don't have audio for it right now. The audio capture isn't your desktop. It's just
the mic
PlayStation
might catch
and
it. But oh yeah, it won't be accessible. Okay.
So if you go back to your desktop capture. Oh, it doesn't have audio. Wait. Why do we not have an audio? It should be picking up in there. That's weird.
Audio output capture?
Oh, because no, you always had it come through the speakers, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Then, unmute audio output capture. No, never mind. Mute the PlayStation.
I was like, twice.
Oh, jeez, it's lagging, huh?
Yep.
Do a transition.
To what?
To your desktop capture.
Oh.
Turn off OBS link.
Hi.
Just quit out of it. Switch over.
And also.
Yeah, unplug the. That's right. Cool. Switch over to Overcooked.
And turn the sound on.
Yep, and I'll let you know how it looks. We're buffering a lot. Yeah, that's because of we're making it do a lot of things at once, and it should hopefully fix itself. That's what I'm hoping.
How do I make the sound? Why would that not be settings?
I have no idea.
Game settings? There we go.
Hopefully y'all can at least hear us.
Can you hear the game?
My game also, like, my stream, like... Oh. It's just showing OBS stuff. Meta OBS, yeah. Why is it still showing the PlayStation stuff?
Weird.
Oh no, okay, cool. I do see the game on here.
But
it's potato mode, yeah. lower the resolution from very high to 1080 or something. If it goes there. Wow. Something under 2000. Yeah, that seems fine.
Quality. Super low.
Yup.
But can you guys see the whole screen? No, right?
With the resolution range, I think it will. This is still very lag. It's not... Wait, is the audio? Oh, the game is a little too loud. Okay.
Oh.
That's interesting, because the only audio is from the mic, which is over there.
Is that the only
audio?
The
game is windowed, yes. We know the game is windowed. We're going to just live with that, hopefully.
But actually, I'm going to make it a little bit louder because I just need to move it onto my lap.
Oh, okay. Us debugging this might be the rest of this game.
Such fun!
This may not work well. Because, yeah, it's not... Okay, wait. Things are looking...
Just going to put this over here so we can see what we're... Ah! Mistakes were made.
Not window capture. Yeah, we can do window capture just because like it would mean changing OBS settings, which we're not going to worry about. But this is still very behind. This is showing. Download module. Great. Love it.
Oh no. Oh, we're bright red. We're green.
Looks good to me. Ship it. All right. They're saying it looks good, so I'm delayed on looking at stuff, but I think that's fine.
Okay. Should I sit in a way that you are in screen?
That's fine. I can just be over here.
Okay.
Let's see how this goes.
Can you guys hear the music at all at this point?
Yeah, do you just hear us talking, or do you also hear the music?
Because I pulled it away.
It was a new scene, but, like, it's not worth futzing with the scene, just because this is an existing one that Lily had. We're coming fine through. Okay, cool.
Worked very hard on that. Alright. Should I give it a try? So, I'm trying to think. The ones that are left are, like, ones that are not necessarily super fun. At least they vex me. I don't know if anyone's watching the thing that would remind you of, but they vex me.
Maggie said I can hear the game and the fan and you guys.
Oh boy. Tee-hee.
Hey Matt.
Hey Matt.
Yes, we were streaming tonight. We finished.
Oh shit. Oh no. Well, all right, we're playing this game.
The game is a little off the screen. You need to move it to the left a little more.
Oh shit. Ah, it's so small. It's so small. What? What's up?
What you're doing. I think it is okay with the adjustment. I really am not paying attention to that.
Doing a thing.
There's no record of it, so it's never happening again.
like the corners of my mind.
I mean, I'll probably wait until the final tonight. Ooh. Like, I won't be able to, like, function if I'm not, like, awake for a while.
I don't have a queen.
I'm quite mumbly as hell. Okay. Let me move my voice closer.
We're gonna have to turn the music down. Oh, actually. Boop. Easy.
Yeah. That seems normal for me, IRL. That's good. Okay. The audio level seems okay for me talking, though.
Okay.
I'm gonna get a little bit closer. Hopefully that's good. Yeah, that fan is definitely coming along. It's
working hard.
So yeah, sorry, this is, sorry, Matt, we finished Shadow of Mordor, and we're just, like, impromptu, like, what could we play for half an hour or so?
Oh, shit.
Because most of the games on the PlayStation that were installed are, like, we would need to play a lot of this and not take a break for 2 weeks after starting it. We were debating Jackbox, but then we realized none of us have Jackbox to actually play. Which, now you're here, we could do Jackbox. But instead, we said we're gonna have Lily do some solo Overcooked for us to show us how it's done. Because she's platinumed almost the whole game.
I will not be platinuming this level.
You seem to be doing amazing.
Thank y'all. Thank you so much.
Oh yeah, Maggie, I am too. I like getting up early on vacation. I feel like I'm wasting vacation if I don't get up early.
Yeah, I went on this trip yesterday and last weekend. come on! Wouldn't have made a difference, but... last weekend, I went upstate with a couple of friends, and we got up at 8 on Saturday to do a hike, and I was just like, I know this will be really fun, and I know that I should do it, but I just don't want to do it. I just don't want to do it so bad. I did it. It was great. But I don't want to do it. Yeah, so my high score on that is 784.
What did you just get?
650-something, 590-something. You will notice that is very close.
Yeah.
That is agonizingly close. I got something like 5 away from a lot of them.
Damn.
Yeah, I'm 10 away on this.
Oh,
infuriating.
That sucks.
Let's see. Okay, I'm pretty far away on that one, over 100. I don't know why I cannot lock that one down.
Oh, Maggie, when she was suggesting Jackbox, is now informing me that she could have actually posted Jackbox for us, but she didn't want to get up and get her computer charger. Which is fair.
That's fair. Fair and valid.
Very, very fair.
Let's see. Yeah. A lot of these ones are harder, but we should switch to them. I just wanted to check my scores. Come on.
Maggie said she won't make you hike that early in the morning.
Thank you. Appreciate you. Appreciate you.
Setting up Jackbox would also take a bunch of time and messing with OBS, and I don't know how much Lily's computer can deal with messing with OBS while streaming.
We can also just end early.
Yeah. I mean, let's do a little bit more Overcooked, just so that, like, we can hang out for a little bit.
Okay,
and,
great.
Like, maybe 2 levels or so, like,
sure.
Nothing crazy. I'm enjoying seeing you, like...
just cut out of existence.
No, it's just, like, it's fascinating to see, like, how you do solo mode of the transfer between the two people and stuff, and, yeah, hiking at 8 a.m. is a lot.
It's a lot.
Waking up at 8 a.m. to get ready to, like, start the day and then go on a hike, that's fine.
Would have been nice.
Like...
Coulda, woulda, shoulda.
Yeah, being, like, 8 o'clock, let's hike.
Oops. Didn't go as planned.
Let's be ready to go.
Like, what if I just, do not fucking want to?
So... Not to interrupt your flow.
Indeed.
But, have you found you've gotten better at throwing things and, like, you have
things for
Dolibus or Duo, basically?
Yes.
Anything else you discover that's, like, interesting, different ways that you play with solo versus
that is a very good question.
Nothing is coming to mind at the moment, but my brain is also, like, not doing a thing at the moment. So let me get back to you on that.
Maggie said, I need my Lily time.
Yes.
Court ordered Lily hours for
one. Yes, please!
Is that separate from stream?
You'll find out. Shit. Ah!
Yeah, Ninja, I'm with you. He's very impressed with how you were soloing. You can only play with someone else, and I feel the same way.
This is the game! Oh, shit.
As Digital C would say, he's mind flooded playing this solo.
It's a very fun, very specific experience.
I feel like doing a solo, I would get more angry at the game. It's like, duo, it's like, okay, cool. We, like, chat about it and, like, figure out how to, like, get together. But solo is like, I just need to actively only myself get better, and I can't, like, talk out that stuff.
What I often will do is, I'll play, like, when I'm stressed at work, I will play a complete one-off.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, jeez. And, oh, God, this is not gonna be a great score. So I'll do a really focused round of three, there's nothing I can do here. A 3-minute round where I just, like, focus all of my attention and all of my frustration into making it just as focused and not having to pay attention to anything else and just pretending everything else doesn't exist. And then I end, oh yeah, I fucked it all up. I end with hopefully a platinum star.
Mm-hmm.
And that is that, but nowhere near it this time around. I think it's 750. 4, 3, 2, 1. Ding, ding, ding.
Maggie said I also prefer solo because I have all the power.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, when we play the game regularly, I fuck up button presses, like,
oh,
every
constantly.
Fifth button
yeah.
press or whatever. I feel like I would fuck up the switching between the characters,
yes.
and I get, like, super angry about, like, no switch, and, like,
I mean, like, I played through the whole thing first
right,
get to the point where I was trying to get these.
Right. I don't know if I would get to the, like, be
mm-hmm.
able to get through the whole game without being like, nah, I'm just
yeah.
done.
Oh, but yeah, sorry. What I will often do, this is what I was starting to say, and then I lost track of what I was talking about. What I will often do is just, like, play and fuck up and just quit the game. Just like,
mm-hmm.
like, all right, I am done. No more playing, and then 2 hours later I'll come back and be like, alright, I have revived.
Mm-hmm. As Megan points out, it's very sad that we can't play Pulls Up with Chris again, because he got so fucking mad at that game. It was very funny. that was great.
True friendship right there,
mm-hmm.
am I right? Oopsies.
Did you end up playing Pulls Up with us or no?
I can't remember if that's one of the ones that I played or if it's a different thing.
It's the one where you're, like, renovating a house, like, room by room kind of thing.
Oh.
You paint, you put up wallpaper, you redo the floors, like, that kind of stuff. And since you pick up a lot of stuff,
oopsies.
You pick people
oh, shit.
Up sometimes.
Ah, fantastic. I think I did that one with you guys. Bless you. Oopsies. Shit. Shit. Oh, shit.
Oh, learning it solo first, right? Yeah, because I think I played it co-op first. I think I played with you before.
I think so.
Actually,
yeah, I mean, it's meant to be played co-op, isn't it?
Oh, yes.
Yep.
Good throw.
Thank you. Thank you for appreciating my skill. this one's ready to go. So, like, I have already done enough to fuck this up. Like, there's no way that I can get the high score. Just because I have not properly utilized my time.
So, like, messing up the first minute, messing up the whole thing. Like, you have to have a perfect...
I have to have a perfect everything, like, right. From the get-go. Let's use it.
Also, they do a thing, and then they keep doing it. I would forget that every time. Which I'd like to pretend that I wouldn't, but I...
Oopsies. No! And around we go. No! Damn it. And you gotta make sure that you pay attention to the timing of, like, if you have meat to cook and cheese to cook. You gotta do the meat first because it takes you it like you have to take the time to chop it and then you also have to take the time to cook it.
Right.
So you gotta pay attention to make sure that you're doing stuff in the right order.
Mm-hmm. Also, one thing that I guess I do really like about like co-op Overcooked versus again hypothetical because I haven't actually played solo mode, but when you are wordlessly getting what needs to get done with someone is such a satisfying feeling.
This is true.
Which, like, you get that solo because you're just, like, in your brain, like, okay, cool, I know what I need to do, I'm doing it in the right order and stuff, but the, like, when you're, like, communicating with somebody, like, hey, can I get this thing, they're like, I have it here for you already. Like,
yeah.
It's just so satisfying.
So true.
You definitely don't get that with solo. But you get other very satisfying things with me. You know your brain works every
time. This is true.
Maggie's also offered up some food in her fridge for you because she won't really eat all the food.
Oh my goodness! Thank you so much.
I also have more details for you about like
yes.
that stuff, which I'll send to you in a text, but also just tell you.
Perfect. Perfect. Love both of those things.
Most of it is sticky notes. Also.
Oh, cool.
Makes life easier to.
Fantastic. Indeed. So yeah, at this point I also can't get anything else in because 25 isn't long enough to cook more food. So I will just
eat a burger with no just cooking.
Because you have to chop it and then you have to cook it. Yeah. So I will just eat myself off of these clips until it is time.
Can that ever be eat yourself
now? This one? Eat.
Nice.
Yep. You can always eat yourself. Yeah, I'm excited. Thank you so much. I'm excited to like...
Wow, that was over 1,000?
Yeah.
Damn.
And I've gotten over 1,000. I just haven't gotten all the way.
Okay.
My high score for this one is 1040, and the minimum for the platinum is 1180.
Yeah. Does everybody see, like, global highest scores on these levels? I'm curious, like, what... Like, how good are some people out there? Stuff.
How would we...
Oh, I assumed it would have been in there.
In there?
Yeah, if it didn't have, like, a button that's, like, global stuff.
Online public.
That's for...
Yeah, I don't think so.
It's like how Mini Metro does.
Yeah.
Like, here's, like, your friend's scores, or, like, global scores and such.
Could play some Mini Metro.
Sure, you want to do a level Mini Metro?
Sure. Mini Metro or Mini Motorways? Chat, y'all pick.
Mini Metro does have new levels.
Oh!
Mini Motorways... Actually, did you play it since they added the, challenges to Mini Motorways?
I don't think so. Let's do that.
Also,
and it's 9:40 already.
The ships are blue.
Mini, thank you! I'm excited to just have a place that is not my home to work from. What am I doing? Video... This guy. Yeah.
You probably could keep. This is a less intense game than Overcooked for like rendering and stuff. So I was thinking that.
We do need it. We need it to fit, though, don't we?
Yes. That is a good point. Yeah. That resize. You might have to make it a little bit smaller.
I think so.
Yeah.
Boop boop. Perfect.
Yeah. If you go to play, so they added the little metal.
Ooh.
And you can add restrictions
Ooh.
For each level. So you can choose one of these, and it'll be like, okay, cool. How about Hollywood? bet at some restrictions, and it'll tell you what they are on the bottom.
Oh, okay. Sure.
Sometimes it's like, cool, you only have highways, or you only have, like, you have unlimited highway, or, like, just different kinds of stuff.
Challenges are a different way to play your favorite maps. Each challenge consists of up to 3 modifiers chosen specifically for that map, and each has its own global leaderboard to climb. You can play challenges as much as you like, so there's always room to improve. Cool. What were you about to say? I'm sorry.
Maggie did say she's never seen Mini Metro.
So yes.
Mini Metro, and then probably call it there.
Fantastic. My only motorway. Start with 1 motorway. No further ones are offered. All destinations are much busier. Double the number of traffic lights awarded. Fuck the traffic lights. Oh my gosh.
Maggie also said you can definitely work from her desk. which it's like, it's a USB-C plug-in thing, so like, you should just plug it in and get to a monitor.
Oh, I can use your monitors? Oh, shit. Thank you.
You might need to move it a little bit to the left.
To the left. Everything only refers to their left. Why you okay? I actually feel like we might just want to quit and do Mini Metro.
Yeah.
Because these ones can take a while.
The objectives you only need to get up to 600 for the like.
Oh.
Goal,
okay.
But like definitely like it's chill to switch off.
Yeah, I'm gonna call it.
Okay. Sorry, by the goal, I mean also just the achievement. You can also just keep going forever, because that's how this
works.
We're at 650, I think. Or 1650 for your resolution.
Oh, thank you. I was like, what? Boop! Yeah. So cute!
Fancy mouse. And her clickety keyboard.
Clickety keyboard!
My PC for hardcore gaming.
All right. Let's play Mini Metro. Ooh, love that sound. So this is Mini Metro. It's just subway stops. So it's just, you start with the 3 lines underneath, 3 different colors. There are different shapes that are different stations that people will show up at a station with a different shape saying they need to get to that shape. So there's a little person at this circle one that needs to get to a triangle, et cetera, et cetera. And the more that you get familiar with it, the more that you'll see that, like, squares tend to be through points. There are way fewer squares than there are basically any other station shape.
Circles are the most common, then triangles, then square, and then there's also, like, one-off shapes that, like plus signs and stuff like that that are, like, super, super obscure.
Mm-hmm.
If you hover over the bottom also,
you can
see, so she's got 2 tunnels, 3 different lines, and 0 cars, because there's only 1 car on each line, but you can get multiple cars per line and such like that, too.
A new locomotive, and I can either get a new line or a carriage. What do we think?
So I try to always get lines until you can't anymore, just because there's a limited supply of them. Getting rid of that means that you then like have that full resource and you never have to worry about that again.
Mm-hmm.
But also, I feel like that's not always a good strat for some maps. And I don't know a deciding thing about when or when it isn't a good strat.
Yeah. Perfect.
We can do New York as the map, but I think this is London, right?
Yeah.
The thing that's also fascinating, which I realized once, like, playing this game, is, like, the way that you naturally develop these subway lines is actually kind of similar to how those cities are structured, which is, like, very wild. Like, the locations are not fully random, but they're kind of random of, like, okay, there'll be, like, some in this area, and then this area, and they'll be different every time you play.
Mm.
But Like, Times Square will be kind of a place that, like, exists on the New York map, but it won't always exist on the New York map. Or it'll live in a slightly different place. Make the yellow line 5,000 stops long and only one connection. Then you've got the G-Train.
Perfect.
There'll be more shapes waiting at the stops, too. Oh, this game picks up very fast.
Mm-hmm.
When you make it to, like, week 4 or so, it starts being like, no, there are lots of people. As you can see by the blue stop already having 6 people on it.
Shit. Nice. I actually think that will be helpful.
I love these games so much because Mini Metro, Mini Motorways, like, on paper, seem like very similar games, but they're so completely different, like...
The vibes!
And it's like, how you approach the problems have to be different. You can't, like, do the same solution for Mini Metro and Mini Motorways or else it doesn't fail,
yeah.
Which is such a cool idea. Such a
Where's the not the triangle, the diamond. Someone was trying to get to a diamond. That one.
Oh, it's on yellow.
Ah, thank you. I guess.
Yeah, so one thing about the game is also every week you always get an extra card.
Wow, so many more squares all right next to each other than I feel like I've ever had. Sorry, didn't mean to cut you off.
No. Yeah, you will always get a new car, so like even if you don't get a new line, you'll have new cars to put on lines, which will help deal with some of the flood, but it's a lot. So one thing that I discovered, which was interesting, but I'm not sure what you can always do about it, is the blue line right now...
Mm-hmm. Which one? Light blue or dark blue?
Light blue. Causes cars to slow down more on the red, yellow, and green lines because it crosses over them.
Interesting.
So, like, having the green line, because it stops there but it goes in a different direction, doesn't do that, but because it bisects it, it causes a slowdown there.
Interesting.
Which, because they don't always stop there, the slowdown is sometimes noticeable, sometimes not. But it's just like another level of like small little things of like micro optimizations you can sometimes do with this game. Of like, okay, cool. How can I get rid of an intersection like this because it slows some stuff down?
Yeah.
You can't, because it's like the square you've got where everything is a hub, like you just need to have it slow down.
But I wonder if now that I have. Fuck!
Oh no, yeah, if you shorten red and then just chuck that over.
I guess.
That's a weird line.
Doesn't
that like.
Oh, red, come on. Shit.
Red is the G.
Oh, wait, do I have another? No, it's in use. Yeah, I don't play this one. I never played this one as regularly as I ended up playing Mini Motorways, so I don't have the,
Because I played this game for a while. Shout out to Rick for introducing this game to me.
Thank you, Rick.
And then also, like, after playing this game for a while, I was like, I'm gonna take a break. And I was like, wait. Like, a year or so later, I know who would love this game. Lily.
Hey,
and
it me!
And then got back into it again, and then...
Oop, I'm about to...
Drop that car, drop that carriage.
Hey.
Okay, sorry. this is a Benji game. Benji likes a lot. He's actually about to go on, like, a vacation and was asking, like, hey, what are some games that I should play? And I was like, what is a good idea? And then we came to the conclusion that he should get Kirby and play that on his Switch for traveling, because he's, like, on a plane for a while.
Cool. Nice.
I have no idea what to recommend. He likes a lot of simulator games, likes a lot of chill games like this, plays a lot of Forza.
I also, like, if I were playing not streaming right now, I would pause, undo all of my stuff, basically, and start from scratch. But...
I do that fast-forward speed, because I just don't like pausing. Pause if, like, a place is about to die, I'll be like, pause.
Right.
Where can I rip a car off of and jam it in here? I do take advantage of the teleporting cars.
Can't wait.
I played Tesla for like 100 hours after having it for 2 weeks.
Nice.
Nice. I start playing as soon as I figure out my
hurt. Oh god. Commit to months.
I want to play the Benji simulator. We just, like, are
shit.
A good person.
Yeah, we're gonna lose. We're gonna lose.
It's not bad.
Oop. Is that on screen? No. My mom just texted me. Yeah, I died.
Good, yeah.
I died, but now you should play. Or...
I don't know if I'd be able to finish.
Alright.
But...
Do you want to try one in the meantime?
I'll do the daily challenge. Because that's usually a thing that, like, ends faster.
Perfect. Oh.
Because, yeah, the daily challenge tends to do weird stuff. Santiago, mode normal. Oh, wait, maybe there are no weird things. Maybe it's just normal.
And that's what's weird.
Then I'll do... Actually, exit menu. I know a thing that will fuck me up real bad.
What's that?
So a thing that I want to do in this game is 100% it. And some of these challenges for the levels are really fucking hard.
Ooh.
One of which is the New York one, which is you have to deliver 1,600 passengers with square stations on no more than 2 lines.
Ah!
So you have to have, like, 2 hub lines that everything moves in and out of.
Oh.
And this is one that I've never been able to actually do, and if I do it now, I'm going to be very mad that it's on your account.
It's going to happen, folks.
No, so my lines will implode.
That it that angle makes it fucked up. So do you ever do?
Yes, but since it's early game, I don't.
Oh, interesting.
I kind of just like throw lines on the like throw shit on the page to like start out and see where things start to develop and then reorganize lines.
Wait, I thought you needed to get them all in 2.
I can only have 2 lines on squares. So red and green are my square lines right now.
Oh.
But as long as I can rearrange my lines and like. Make purple there as long as something else isn't there, and then
Got
it's fine.
That sucks. I feel like I would just accidentally without thinking.
So, originally in the game, if you accidentally did it and didn't pay attention, you would not get the achievement. They added this wonderful feature where if you do it, it stops and is like, hey,
aww.
This breaks the rule. And then you can like turn it off or turn it back on.
I love that. I love that so much.
That was one reason I came back to the game, was because they're like, hey, this is easier to handle.
Yeah.
It pauses it for you, like it's.
Nice. Improvements!
It's one of my favorite features they added in the game.
Yeah.
But as you can kind of see from just like.
Sorry,
minimal,
I was reading a text from my mom. I apologize, chat.
One that's like minimal here. We're already starting to develop. There are 2 different lines going north and south, Brooklyn and Queens. Like, it's just. You're already getting the weirdness that is New York. Although I am going through. Are there any lines that go through Central Park? Is that possible? Oh, no, that's going to fuck it up.
Oopsies.
Ooh, that way. Yeah.
So there's, like, Columbus Circle right next to Central Park?
Right, there's, like, things that go up the sides.
Yeah, like, AC goes up the side.
Does anything go underneath it?
Does anything go underneath Central Park? That's a good question. I'm not sure. Excuse me. Rand, are you moved in?
Yeah. Also, one thing that this game does do, which kind of is shitty, is that they include Jersey City.
Yeah.
In New York, which makes it much harder to actually do this because they add so many stops in Jersey City.
So now it's the path.
Yeah, blue is the path. That checks out. Yeah. So, like, one reason I kind of just, like, YOLO it for the beginning is that putting a triangle on every line is super useful, and looking to see where the triangles pop up to reorganize and handle that is, like, cool. Let's just see what happens until we get a little ways in. Because now I don't have to worry about that other line. What do I want to do here? I'm going to connect north and south, because I was just going to be anti-New
York.
Let's do that.
Oh, a line goes along Central Park, but not through Central Park. Yep.
Okay.
Ah, congratulations! That's so exciting!
Yeah.
We have to celebrate on your block.
Yeah.
There's a bar with a pool table. Ooh.
Oh, wait, shit. Okay, so now I need to actually start thinking. Okay, so red and purple will have that on there.
Oh, it doesn't have to be the same, too. It can't just be red and green. It can be something other than red
and
green.
Yes, this is where I'm going to actually start redoing the whole map. So
got
red
it.
Will connect here. Red is no longer going into Queens.
Fun!
Orange is going to handle that way.
This is very fun. Oh, I like this a lot.
Here, green will loop around for now, but might not later. And then purple can connect to here, because it can also be squares.
Yeah. There's a bar on your block with a pool table. and yummy drinks. We should all you guys are going away.
We'll
Rand, you and I should celebrate.
Oh, shit.
Let's hang out.
I have tunnels. Shit.
Yeah, ABCD runs on the Weast.
We're gonna ignore the football.
Oh, okay.
Because it's Saturday and I need another tunnel. and if they don't give me a tunnel, this is gonna be some fuckery happening, which is gonna be fun. Locomotive. Bridge is cool.
Nice.
Okay. So we will have red just go up there, because that makes sense. We've got a... an extra car in our back pocket.
This is where it gets painful for me. Like, this is unpleasant. Yes! Ninja, let's do it. When is the next time I am free?
So related to what I was saying of, like, the stops, I'm moving that off of the square because it means that this will technically move faster. Because this is already a hub that needs to be a hub. This will be our... little bit of speed there of like micro optimizations.
Nice.
We need our orange car.
Perfect.
Orange needs some more cars to go.
Yeah, we don't need to go to Mexico. Mexico will come to us. Ooh, that's rough.
Yeah, why is this car not moving?
Because it's such an intense angle, I think. Maybe not.
No, sometimes when you plop a car, they just like stop and think for a while and so purple is now gonna go along here and just help out a little.
That's the struggle.
Yeah, I'm gonna get a carriage to help out there. Jersey City's still kinda F, but that's fine. And we're gonna have a teleporting point. Oh, slow down, I didn't stop time. We're just gonna go up here and get some free time. Hello? I'm gonna go here.
I don't think it can when it's full.
No, because it should drop off the cars at the station.
Huh.
Not interesting. Alright, well, you are gonna turn around, because you're gonna actually listen this time. Yeah, that is my favorite thing to do in this game, just be like, you actually go here.
Cool.
And now this extra carriage is actually in a joint red, because that's the one that will actually need to deal with it, not being made.
I don't know, orange is still struggling.
I think orange will stabilize, but maybe not.
Does green maybe want to stop at one of the orange circles?
Yeah, I'm not sure if it will do that much. That wasn't what I meant to, but that was not terrible.
Oh there's a circle up top that's going. That north central node def act in all time squarey.
Yeah, Jersey City fucked me up.
Boom.
That was also kind of intentional because it's after 10.
Yeah, it's after 10.
I didn't want to go for too long. But, yeah, there we go.
All right. So
we're just on Infinite Discords now. Yep.
Cool. Oh, wait. Is that actually... Wait, no. Go back.
No, you're not connected to the PlayStation.
I'm not?
PlayStation's off.
Is it?
It's not plugged
into here. We turned it off?
Yeah.
No, but remember, the link doesn't mean that we turned the PlayStation off.
Oh, PlayStation is still on.
Yeah, we have to turn it... We have to put it back in to actually be able to turn it off correctly. But anyways... I feel like this game just doesn't match with my brain. That's fair. That's valid.
Cool.
But yes, we did it. We beat Shadow of Mordor. Yay. Thank you, Digital C. It just looks pulsing. That's fair. That's a good,
such
a good description.
I don't know if you guys could hear the music, though. Like, it is
such good music.
Good, calming music with, like, it's completely, like, procedurally generated, but, like, also composed to be to be generated. It's so good.
It's also, like, the opposite of what I would use Overcooked for. Of, like, Overcooked is, like, I just need a 3-minute break to completely refocus my brain. So I'm going to play 3 minutes of very, very stressful focus and then go back to work. Whereas Mini Metro would be like, I just need to relax my brain for a minute.
And also, you can play it in free mode where it doesn't have, like, restrictions. And you just be like, I'm going to make a beautiful Metro system. And, like... People will build up somewhere, but, like, they won't get angry and destroy and just burn the building down. They'll be like, all right, I'll wait.
Lovely. That's not a real human thing.
I mean, burning the building down is a little bit extreme.
It's fine. Shmordor. Oh, good. Glad to hear the music came through.
Cool.
Yes, all right. So we're taking 2 weeks off for vacation fun things.
Mm-hmm.
Some of us will be going to Mexico. Some of us will be bringing Mexico to us. And both of those are valid and relaxing.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Interesting. It sounded buzzy and anxious.
Interesting. I wonder if that was the fan also adding noise
maybe
to it or something.
Or I wonder also, I'm so curious now actually, Matt, if you would find this game, the whole thing, just super stressful and it's just not how your brain works.
It's entirely possible.
Yeah.
But I do, I mean, the artist is Disaster Piece. Like, you can listen to the Mini Metro like soundtrack on Spotify if you want to like hear it independent of the game too. Because like, yeah, it's...
For sure. Cool. All right. Sorry. It's time. We will be back in 2 weeks. Until then, thank you all for being here as always. I hope you have a wonderful 2 weeks. Hopefully we will see you again on the other side. Until then, stay sane, stay safe, stay healthy.
Bye.